So at E3 2018, I got to play Wolfenstein 2, The New Colossus, on Switch in handheld mode. They did not have a docked mode available to play, or I probably would have checked that out as well. For those who don't know, I am a huge fan of the first game in the series. Now, when I say first, I'm talking about the rebooted version of Wolfenstein, because Wolfenstein is actually a very old IP that goes back many, many years that I remember my dad playing on old school PCs way back in the 90s. However, Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus is actually a sequel to Wolfenstein A New Order. And I played the first game on PC and beat the main campaign. I don't really remember a whole lot about the main campaign, not because the story was bad, just because it was a while ago and I've played a lot of games since. But I remember the gameplay. And the gameplay was utterly fantastic. It was extremely fluid. I played at 60 FPS on PC. And that is something that's a bit of an adjustment when I played it on Switch, because it's obviously not 60 FPS, just like Doom before it, that Panic Button also ported over, because Panic Button is handling the port of Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus. It does not run at 60 FPS, nor do I expect it to on hardware like the Switch, not without the resolution dropping to something that I would deem unusable. I mean, I know there's been talks about how Paladins in portable mode drops down to, like, you know, 360p and stuff like that, like, you know, one of the lowest resolutions on YouTube, but it needs to be even worse than that to hit 60 FPS on Wolfenstein. It would have to be like 160, 120, and that's unplayable. Like, there's sacrifices to be made for FPS, and then there's literally unplayable because you're just looking at a blob on screen, and that's what would have to happen for these games to be at 60. So I'm fine with Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus on Switch not being at 60. It was a little bit of an adjustment from what I'm used to, because this is the first time I played it on Switch, but that's okay. I gotta say, the area we got to play in was an enclosed area, so we were not outdoors. It was a rather large room in some sort of factory, which was really neat. And there was a lot of different facets and a couple puzzle elements, because it didn't hold your hand, right? You're kind of dropped into the beginning of entering this room, and there's enemies everywhere. There's cover. There's different things to do. There's key cards you have to find, which is a classic thing from Wolfenstein and, like, Doom back in the day and stuff like that. So very much into that. And there's a little bit of storytelling. I don't remember much of the story because I was kind of holding the Switch away from me, so Eric could get really good footage. The footage you're seeing now is what he was able to get, obviously off camera, off screen of portable mode. I don't know if there's even a way to capture portable mode at all unless it's off screen. I don't even think Digital Foundry's figured that out. But I will say this, as someone who played a lot of Doom last year, or relatively a lot of Doom, and then played Wolfenstein this year on Switch, it is smoother than I remember Doom being. I went back and I tried out Doom again just yesterday, just to reconfirm my thoughts after rewatching this footage of Wolfenstein. And sure enough, I find Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus is actually smoother. Is that because there's less particle effects? I don't know. Maybe Panic Button just got better at porting the ID Tech 6 engine after having that experience with Doom. Whatever the case is, I felt it was smoother. I felt there were less dips. Now, that doesn't mean there weren't dips, because it's not a locked 30 FPS. But the dips I experienced were usually in the middle of melee animations, and those are canned anyways, so the FPS doesn't really matter as much during melee animations, because there's some pretty gruesome melee kills, just like there is in Doom. There's actually a lot of similarities between these games in terms of play style. Obviously, one's about killing demons, the other one's about, well, killing Nazis. In a Nazi occupied United States. This is basically an alternate reality where the Nazis ended up winning World War II. Hitler was not killed or did not commit suicide or whatever the case may be. As I don't think we 100% know how he died, just that he did. But yeah, it's very interesting looking back at this revisionist history style game and dealing with the worst possible outcome from that moment in history. And the high technology, you get to see some of the tech in action with some certain enemies that were like robots. It was pretty insane. Most of the characters I ended up fighting were fellow humans that were just decked out in, you know, new age body armor and stuff like that. But it was very, very fun. It was very fluid, way more fluid than I even remember Doom being last year. And that's kind of my takeaway from Wolfenstein 2, is that it is just a more well-polished port to Switch. And that's saying something, considering that by now, after some patches and stuff, Doom is pretty smooth. And yet, I still found Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus even smoother. Now, there's always going to be a bit of a letdown with this game, you know, coming out in just a week, because it was announced before the game released anywhere else last year, right? So some people wanted this game to be day and date. And can I blame them for wanting a day and date game? Well, we need day and date treatment as Switch owners. And it does feel weird because right now, there is currently no big Bethesda game announced as coming to Switch. Fallout 76, as far as we're aware, is not coming to Switch. Rage 2, as far as we're aware, is not coming to Switch. And we're not even sure the next Doom or Wolfenstein Youngblood are coming to Switch either. Now, there is a rumor of a panic button announcement coming in July. That's a major IP. I assume that's going to be the next Doom game, but again, assumptions. So setting that aside, I'm picking up Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus. I wasn't sure if I was going to because of how late the port was coming, but after playing it at E3, I've been putting off playing it on other devices to decide if I was going to get it on Switch or get it on PC, and I'm going for the Switch version because I want to play it anywhere. It worked in handheld mode so well that I don't know if I'm even going to stream the game to you guys because I'm going to be playing so much handheld mode. But that's okay. I have Mario Tennis Aces and other games I can stream for you guys at this point, but yeah, I'm actually going to be picking it up instead of getting Crash Insane Trilogy, even though the Crash Insane Trilogy is cheaper, just because, I don't know, I'm not exactly happy with how, with what it took to get Crash Insane Trilogy on Switch. The methodology of the one person who loves Switch being able to convince, you know, Activision and Visceral to bring it, like, it just, Not really something I want to worry about, but and yes, I realize I just said Visceral Games. I realize that's not what it is. My bad. I know it's a studio for the V. Poor old Visceral. I miss you guys. I miss you before I even knew you. But that's kind of my takeaway, I think, on Wolfenstein 2 The New Colossus, is it runs very, very well. The story, the little bit of story they had in the demo was fantastic. In handheld mode, I was not bothered at all. Someone's going to ask. Someone's going to want to know, did it run at sub-HD? Probably, because Doom runs at sub-HD sometimes. Did I notice while I was playing? No. And that's kind of the big thing people forget when they hear about these sub-HD things, like what happened with Paladins, is on that tiny of a screen, it is so hard to tell at times. Because the pixel density is smaller, right? When you shrink down a screen, the less and less you actually notice if it's 720p, if it's 1080p, etc. So in the case of Switch, max it can be a 720, and it can be running at 640 or 580, and I guarantee you personally are not going to be able to even tell when that's happening, especially in motion, with motion blur and everything else going on. The game's just fantastic. I have zero complaints. If you were on the fence about Wolfenstein 2 because of how it performed on the platform, all I could say is, at least in this enclosed, massive room with, I think I killed over 18 different enemies that were present in this room, and they were all there from the beginning. I gotta say, go pick it up, man. If you've been waiting for it, get it, because the Switch version is fantastic, and we need to keep showing companies like Bethesda that we want their latest and greatest games, that we want Rage 2, that we want Beyond Good and Evil 2, that we want Fallout 76, or any sort of Fallout game that isn't just Fallout Shelter. These are the kind of games, when they're this high quality of a port, we need to support. All right, folks, that's all I got to say. I will catch you guys in the next one.